See, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai ran a great deal because it was made with a lot of conviction of a person who believed in the film. It was like a 25-year-old's outlook towards life, what he would want college to be, what he would want romance to be. I know Karan Johar, he's a very nice bloke and he's a very nice guy. And he's looking at life through rose-colored glasses, and right now it suits all of us to look at life that way because everything is so cynical, there's so much of pessimism, there are so many deaths, extortions, and a lot of unfortunate things happening. So we want to forget all that. We want some escapist fare. And this is like spandex fluff. It's like I would say, it's like bubblegum pink. Something we want to see, the way we would like to see life today.
Was Karan's the debut of the year? Is he the most promising young director to watch out for?
For a first film, Karan was definitely the debut of the year. But otherwise, I thought one of the most path-breaking films was Satya, Ram Gopal Verma's Satya. I thought it was a very well-made film, and which made a statement also. I mean, what statement did Kuch Kuch Hota Hai make? I'm not in any way trying to demean it, but what I'm saying is that entertained all the way, whereas Satya did make a statement.
Satya also stood out because there was this whole bunch of romantic films, and this was, I think, one of the sole exceptions.
Right.
How did the audience accept this?
Not really. Satya wasn't the only film of this genre. There was also Gulam. Though Gulam was a little more, again, commercial eye. The director had a commercial eye for. Whereas Satya, like I said, was like as stark as a charcoal sketch. It was very black and white, and the underworld was represented as it would be if I was to step out and go to some streets of Bombay in the night. And it was very realistic. Gulam was more, again, a little more colourful. Not as colourful as some of the Akshay Kumar adventures, but definitely it was, again, slightly with a commercial eye.
What makes Satya so important?
Satya makes you empathize with the criminals, but not to the extent that you feel that they should get away scot-free. You do feel that death is the only redemption for criminals. And it also makes you think that once you're on this path, there is no coming back. It's a one-way street. And it's a very mean street. And also how certain middle-class people get unwittingly involved. I mean, if he's your next-door neighbor and you don't have a clue as to what he could be an underworld don, or he could be working for him, and you interact with him. That was the tragedy of Urmila. And I could understand what she felt in the end, you know, when she was so petrified and so confused about the whole issue.
About Manoj
Bajpayee's
portrayal of Bikku Mantri, what do you think?
I think Manoj Bajpayee will get all the awards this year. He should get all the awards. If anybody else gets the award, it won't be fair. I mean, his role was so down to earth, so realistic, and it wasn't gimmicky. He did not indulge in any mannerisms like doing this, or, you know, any kind of raising a collar. It was free of mannerisms, and yet it was so impactful. That was what I made. I thought, like Ram Gopal Verma said, that he thought he's one of the finest actors. He's the finest actor he's worked with. And he also said that I just felt he became the character. It was not like he was trying to get into the character's shoes or anything. He was the character. For that span of time when the camera was whirring, he was the character.
Coming to, I think, the most talked about film of the year was Dil Se, one of the most talked about. Why do you think it flopped? Why do you think it did well?
Dil Se flopped because there was a lot of ambiguity. We didn't know who the protagonists were fighting against. We didn't know why Manisha made the trip to Ladakh. And the songs, I thought, though each song was a very beautifully choreographed number, but what were they doing? They were jutting out like, you know, like, they were just jutting out in the film. They did not blend with the film. Especially this, I think, if I remember correctly, the Satrangi song just came out of the blue, and you know, you didn't know what it was doing there. I like the climax, though, of the film. Again, the climax would have been far more effective if it was shot at the parade itself, instead of this guffa or cave, wherever it was supposed to be. I don't know what they were doing. Why did they shoot it there? Maybe it would have been difficult to handle a crowd scene. I don't know what was the technical restriction for not shooting it at the Republic Day Parade, or was it the Independence Day Parade? One of the two. It would have been far more interesting if it had been shot against that backdrop.
Well, these are like small mistakes in the film.
Right.
Why did it really not communicate at all to
the... Because the core issue did not get communicated to the audience. What was the film trying to say? And was Shah Rukh a patriot first and a lover later? Or was he a lover first and a patriotic later? And why did he agree to marry Preeti Zinta? You know, these small things which you're saying, that you're saying these are all small, they build up. The audience starts losing, gets disenchanted with a film and it doesn't hold. And when they can't tie in the loose threads, then they don't kind of enjoy the film. They come out with a feeling of dissatisfaction. I came out feeling dissatisfied from Dil Se. Though, like I said earlier, I love the climax of the film. But that's okay. I think they are entitled. They have given us so many successes. They've given us so much entertainment earlier. I loved Roja more than Bombay. And I love Bombay more than Dil Se, in that order. So I think they're entitled to make a few mistakes as they go along.
How much importance would you give to Govinda's presence and the success of Pademia shooting?
You know, I would give as much credit to Amitabh Bachchan as I would give to Govinda. Now, you'll ask me why, of course. The simple reason is that I thought what Amitabh did was he kind of let Govinda steal the thunder. And Laurel and Hardy or Terence Hill and Bud Spencer, whenever there's a team working, one of them has to play the underdog and the other has to get the laughs off him, you know. It's like striking a matchstick of a matchbox. So Amitabh was the matchbox and Govinda was the matchstick, and that's how I thought Govinda came out so alive. So in his own way, Amitabh did contribute to Govinda's performance.
Would you like to add anything more to the talk about Satya, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, Dil Se, Bade Miyan Chote Miyan? Have you missed out anything?
There were a lot of films that did well besides these, but they were all from the same family, the popcorn variety, like Jab Pyar Kisi Se Hota Hai, Jab Pyar Kiya Toh Darna Kya. Then these were the, basically, if you go to see all the films, were those what I would call rom-coms. By rom-coms, I mean romantic comedies. That was the base of all these films, and parental opposition was made too much of. And I think we are now going to the other extreme. First, we had those boys and girls running away from home and jumping off cliffs like in Bobby, and or running away and making a home like in Love Story. And now we have them running in the opposite direction back home to their parents and giving parents too much importance. I think we are adult enough at 21, 22 to know what we want from our lives. And I think, I don't know why we're calling this Indian culture of not marrying the girl you want to because your parents don't approve of. But is that Indian culture? I don't know. I don't think so.
Now coming to the controversy created by fire, what do you think about the whole issue? Your opinion.
Could you ask me more specifically what you want to ask me? In what way do I think of the...
Well, we basically looking at the disruption of the film screening.
Right. Right.
Do you think that was right? Do you think one should take a stand against this kind of vandalism?
See, what I feel is, you take up any issue, no two people are going to agree on it. There's going to be a difference of point of view. Even the way about my attitude about, like for instance, I would find it objectionable if I saw a film where they show that the daughter-in-law is being tortured by her mother-in-law, and in the ending, the daughter-in-law says, but all said and done, you're still my mother-in-law. That would repel me, that would anger me. But that does not mean I can go and... if I have a problem, I'll go to I'll take some legal recourse. I might go and make it an issue and raise it in a legal fashion. So I feel that's the way anything which you feel hurts your sensibilities or your aesthetics, and you want to do something about it, I think you should take legal recourse. And In any, whether a star and a journalist also have a disagreement, the recourse should be something more acceptable, what is according to the norm, and not indulge in anything which is leaves a sense of unpleasantness, because we want to resolve the issue. The idea is to resolve the issue, not to fan it further, not to fan the fire, to say, as to say.
Did you watch the film? What did you think of it? Did it offend you? Did you find it funny, or did you find it?
Like I said, I find more offensive is crude comedy. What I find more offensive is scenes where they glorify a mother-in-law because she's a mother-in-law, even if she's harassing the daughter-in-law. These films hurt my sensibilities. I'm not affected by fire. I can understand in the sense like it's a story, it's a point of view of Deepa Mehta about two women seeking female bonding. And of course, I have my reservations about how it was projected, but those are very, like from a critic's point of view. But I have no problem with the screening of the film. I mean, people can decide for themselves. But what I feel we should do is, instead of having just universal and an adult certificate, we should have other ratings, like they have abroad, like to be seen with parental guidance or recommended for viewers above it so and so. Because we cannot have self-censorship in this country. Self-censorship is very, it sounds like utopian, it sounds very good. But what is there then to stop the jungle ki betis and this kind of stuff to come in, where they will contend that, look, you have a problem with it, but the other viewers, and I'm sure lots of people don't have, because if you go to see, there are certain theaters earmarked for these kind of films. And these films do very good business there. I don't know who goes to see them, but a lot of people do go to see them, obviously. Otherwise, they wouldn't be coming out so regularly. So self-censorship is not feasible. It's not practical. And a very rigid censorship is not the answer either. So we have to, I think, moderation, like in everything else in life, moderation is the best way out. And
do you think it is time to stand up against such vandalism?
Like I said earlier, see, you can't say why another person doesn't share my point of view. Whether it is the people who we are saying are indulging in vandalism or the people who are claiming that this film should be have unrestricted screening. See, there are no absolutes in life. So you have to strike a balance. And the way about it is going about it is, if you have a problem with a film or a book or anything written, you go take legal recourse or whatever laws of the country allow you to do and follow that course of action, is what I feel. That's a better way of going about it. I'm not saying you have to toe the line and agree to what, say, Fire is saying or Arunadithi Roy is saying or anybody is saying for that matter. You, if you have a difference of opinion, you go about it in a more reasonable fashion.